Welcome students to the new biology session. We are going to start with our fourth chapter of unit reproduction, that is reproductive health. What is reproductive health? Reproductive health means healthy reproductive organs and their normal functioning. According to WHO, reproductive health means total well-being in all aspects of reproduction, that is physical, emotional, behavioral and social. A reproductively healthy society is a society with the people having physically and functionally normal reproductive and normal emotional and behavioral interaction among them in all sex-related aspects. The problems which are being faced during the reproductive health. Number one, there is a little knowledge of personal hygiene and hygiene of reproductive organs. Hygiene means cleanliness. Number two, early marriages lead to high maternal and infant mortality rate, matlab death rate. Due to the lack of awareness, there is a rapid increase in the population size. People encourage beliefs in myths and misconceptions about sex-related issues. To overcome those problems, the Government of India has established some steps, that is the strategies. India is the first country to initiate the action plans, programs at national level to attain total reproductive health. These programs are, number one, family planning, were initiated as soon as in 1951. Number two, reproductive and child health care, RCH. So full form of RCH is Reproductive and Child Health Care program were launched in 1997 for, number one, creating awareness among people about various reproduction related aspects. Number two, providing facilities and support for building up reproductively healthy society. So what type of the particular environment should be there, how to create the healthy atmospheric conditions, that is the main task of RCH, that is reproductive and child health care. Number third, with the help of audiovisual aids and print media, both government and non-government, that is NGOs, are engaged in creating awareness among the people about the reproduction related aspects. You must have seen various ads in the newspapers and the posters coming out. So they are giving the awareness among the people about the reproduction and how to control the population. Number fourth, encouraging sex education in the schools. Why? To give right information to the young minds and save them from myths and misconceptions. Jo galat dharnaye hain, unse bachane ke liye, the encouragement of the sex education in the school should be there. Fifth, educating people about available birth control options, that how you can control the birth rate, care for the pregnant mothers, postnatal care of mother and child. Postnatal means after the delivery of the child. Importance of breastfeeding, equal opportunities for male and the female child. So these are the various steps and strategies which are being taken place by the India to attain the total reproductive health. Population explosion. What is population explosion? The increase in the size and the growth of population is called population explosion. What are the reasons for that? Number one, rapid decline in death rate because of increasing the facilities of the health. medical facilities becomes more modern, more available. So because of that, there is a rapid decline in death rate. Number two, decline in maternal mortality and infant mortality rate. Maternal means mother and infant means child. So they are also declining because of the better facilities, better care. Now, what steps is being taken to control the population growth? Number one, raising marriageable age of the girl up to 18 years and boys up to 21 years. There should be no child marriage. Number two, incentive should be given to the couple with a small family. The small family couples or small family should be given some incentives in the form of scholarships, in the form of some other strategies they must have given. Number third is motivate the couple to use contraceptive method, that is to control the birth rate for the small families. Advertisements in the media as well as a poster bills showing the happy family with the slogan Hum Do Hamare Do, One Child Norms. So these are the various steps which we should, the government has taken so that there should be a control on the population growth rate. So to control the population growth, the most important step is to use various contraceptive methods that is being known as the birth control methods. What should be the ideal contraceptive should be user-friendly, easily available, effective and reversible with no or least side effect, no interfering with the sexual drive, desire and or the sexual act of the user. So these should be the various features which should be there in the contraceptive method so that they can be used in a very friendly manner and help to control the population growth. Methods of the birth control. The contraceptive methods are divided into the following categories. Number one is your natural method. Number two, barrier method. Then intrauterine devices, that is IUD. Number fourth is your oral contraceptives. Then injections and implants. And the last one is your surgical method. So these methods are being used to keep the gap between the two child and to control the birth rate. So we will discuss each method one by one. So first we are taking is the natural methods. These are natural methods that work on the principle of every contraceptive method has its own principle on which it works. That is, and the natural method principle is avoiding the meeting of ovum and sperm. Means there should be no fusion between the ovum and sperm. And the main principle of the natural method, there should be no meeting between ovum and sperm, no fertilization so that we can control the birth rate. Under the natural methods, we will discuss number one is periodic abstinence is a method in which the couple avoids or abstain from coitus from day 10 to 17 of the menstrual cycle when ovulation is expected. The menstrual cycle is of 28 days. The first 5 days is a bleeding phase. 6th to 14th day is the multiplication phase. 14th is the ovulatory phase when the ova is there in the fallopian tube for the fertilization. And during that days, the couple should avoid coitus from that day when ovulation is there, and then they can avoid the meeting of ovum and the sperm. The second is coitus interruptus or withdrawal is a method in which the male partner withdraws his penis from the vagina just before ejaculation so as to avoid the insemination. If there will be no insemination, no fusion between the male and the female gametes, and they can avoid the fertilization. The last natural method is your lactational amenorrhea. is based on the principle that during the period of lactation, lactation period means that is the period that is of the breastfeeding after the delivery of the child, ovulation does not occur, no formation of ova, no fusion between the male and the female gamete, no fertilization, and that is again the natural method by which we can avoid the fertilization and we can control the birth rate. So these three methods comes under the heading of the natural method. So till then, goodbye, thank you, and our next lesson will be on other contraceptive methods. Thank you.